Today we're tasting a well-known and popular white wine, Pinot Grigio. You may have seen two different terms for this wine. There is a Pinot Gris, which is from France, and Pinot Grigio, which is the Italian term, but they're both the same wine. And in the US, we most commonly see Pinot Grigio because it's imported more often from Italy than France, so we're seeing more Pinot Grigio, but in the end, it's the same wine, the same grape, though it will have different tasting profiles, which we'll get into. Pinot Grigio is a great wine for beginners. It's easy to drink, very approachable and affordable. It's so common in the US as well that annually $1 billion of Pinot Grigio is sold. Pinot Grigio didn't really gain popularity in the US until mid-1990s when producers were determined to spread the word about Pinot Grigio, and since then has gained the popularity that we see today. Pinot Grigio originated in France, but today is grown in countries such as the US, Canada, Germany, Czech Republic, Italy, Slovenia, Hungary, Romania, Moldova, Australia, and New Zealand. The Pinot Grigio grape matures rather quickly, making it one of the first varietals harvested in the year. The grapes are ready to be harvested as early as late August, and it takes about 6 months to produce this wine, and it's ready to be sold around winter, early spring. The first thing you'll notice about this white wine is its crisp, very golden looking color. It's similar to a Sauvignon Blanc, but when I first poured this wine, it did look a little cloudier, and when you compare it side by side, you'll be able to see that distinct difference. The wine color is also easier to see with a white piece of paper behind it so that you can truly see its unique color, and when you're comparing it to other white wines, you'll be able to see it more clearly as well. Next, we'll go ahead and swirl the wine, releasing its unique honey and floral notes. Swirling the wine helps oxidize as well as bring out the flavors, and it'll overall give you a more enjoyable wine tasting experience. A note to have on this wine as well, that white wines are usually chilled between 45 to 55 degrees Fahrenheit, but don't drink it right away after you take it out of the fridge. Make sure that it cools down a bit so that the coldness of the wine doesn't dull the flavors. Next, we can go ahead and smell the wine, and the notes that usually come out, you'll notice, are honey or floral, ginger, perhaps some saline. There are a lot of styles of Pinot Grigio, so the notes may differ depending on the style that you have, but typically you'll notice some honeysuckle or the floral notes as mentioned. When tasting a Pinot Grigio, you'll notice light fruit flavors such as pear, nectarine, citruses, apple, melon, and peaches. Pinot Grigio also leans towards the semi-dry, acidic taste, so you'll notice this when sipping it as well. Let me know in the comments below what you catch in your Pinot Grigio. The best thing about wine tasting is getting to pair your wine with food. The food pairings are great with Pinot Grigio. It's very diverse and often much better when you're tasting it with food. And for main dishes, seafood is ideal, things like mussels or ceviche, as well as chicken. If you're having a Pinot Grigio from France, so a Pinot Gris, usually creamier dishes, creamy pasta dishes, or potato au gratin are much better with this wine. For veggies, golden potatoes are great any way that you bake them or fry them. French fries are also delicious with Pinot Grigio. For cheeses, goat cheese and Gruyere are great, and for desserts, you cannot go wrong with crepes or creme brulee. If you love Pinot Grigio, hit that like button and click here to try another delicious white wine.